Camp nearly done. Coming up to the last couple of days now of what has been 3 weeks, or will have been 3 weeks, of camp out in Spain. So yeah, I wanted to mainly use this as getting a lot of bike miles in was my sort of main focus. Getting some fast running back in, because I've been, obviously January was kind of getting back into running properly. So this has been my, to reintroduce some speed, get some sessions in. And then obviously still the big focus on the swim, doing the front pack swim sessions and trying to change my stroke. So I think all in all, I'd say very successful camp. Like, I've got lots of bike miles in, really good bike miles. Got some good swim sessions in, and actually really happy with where the run is, considering that's been my first like proper sessions back. So that's all kind of going the right direction, which is nice. And the last week the sun has come out properly, which is also really nice. So yeah, I think overall as camp, couldn't have really gone much better, other than if I'd actually had my TT bike, so I had power and could ride the TT bike. But in some ways it's also been quite nice just having the road bike and being able to just ride with the group, enjoy riding without it feeling as kind of almost, not like pressured is the wrong word, but kind of feel like on the TT bike it always feels a bit like it's a bit antisocial. It's very much like I'm doing this because it's a session. It kind of, it's felt more relaxed having just the road bike. I've not had the TT bike because UPS are useless, basically. It's still stuck in Bristol, apparently for a customs check, but that customs check has taken nearly 3 weeks now. So, I mean, at least it's still in the UK in some ways. It doesn't seem to have shipped itself off to some random country. Hopefully it'll get sent back so it's home before I get home. So yeah, the numbers, everyone wanted to know all the numbers. So I'm gonna do it week by week because I basically didn't really want to have to add it all up. So I'm going off what Training Peaks shows me, because that's the easiest way of doing it. So I obviously arrived on the Friday after a day trip to LA. So those first 3 days were actually just chilled. So I'm not gonna talk through them because it was just to kind of get through stuff. So the first proper week, going from the 6th of Feb to the 12th of Feb, I totaled 31 and a quarter hours. That's with two recovery days. Like, the Monday was kind of recovery, mainly with it just still being quite relaxed as opposed to proper recovery. And the Friday was kind of more proper recovery with it just being swim and gym. So that was 7.5 hours of swimming, which was like 22K. As I said before, I'm not doing massive mileage at the moment. It's much more like 25s, 50s, focus on technique and really try and change that stroke. The bike, I did 17.5 hours and 430K. So it's like, again, it's actually quite low mileage out here because it's, A, it's really hilly, and B, that first week I actually did a couple of gravel rides. So they're like super slow, like averaging like 20K an hour. Not as much distance as you would get somewhere else. That was 8,000 meters of elevation that week. So that shows kind of how hilly it was. And I did 4 hours of running, and that was 50K of running. So yeah, that first week I was doing maybe a bit less running than I am now, because I did my first couple of tempo sessions, so it was getting back to it. And I missed the Saturday run because I was ill on the Friday night. Also dialed back the ride that I was meant to do on Saturday. So first week was like a little bit less than it would have been, but still a really solid week. The people that want the random Training Peaks numbers that I don't actually look at that much, it says my fitness was 113 CTL and my fatigue was 144 ATL. My TSS was 1066. But again,
without power.
I'm not with power, so it's doing it all off like the heart rate one, which is obviously a bit different because usually it's doing it off power. So that was week one. Week two was a total of 34 and a quarter hours, so a little bit more. Again, similar, sort of Monday was more relaxed, Friday was pretty chilled. That was a total TSS of 1150. 20 and a half hours on the bike and 530k, again, quite slow kilometers. My swim must have been similar, kind of 7.5 hours, 20k of swimming. The run was 5.25 hours and 65k of running. I am manually entering my swim, so I get no TSS for my swims. That also doesn't feed in. And then, yeah, from the other numbers on that, that's like 121 CTL fitness score and 172 ATL fatigue. This week again is going to look a bit different because I've got a couple of travel days. So in total, I'm expecting it to be about maybe 23, 24 hours. That's with having a pretty chilled Friday, and then Saturday will also be quite chilled because we're basically traveling to South Africa. So I won't land there until mid-afternoon, so I'm not sure what I'll be able to get done on Saturday. So the main days will be like this, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, of doing like my track session today, long ride tomorrow, bike session Thursday, kind of key sessions. So overall, it would have been a pretty solid sort of 3 weeks. I guess probably if I took it from like the Fridays to the Fridays, it would end up being on average over 30 hours a week, which is kind of what I wanted in terms of getting that extra bike miles. Like generally feeling much fitter, which is nice, like especially running. I think the kind of building back into it quite slowly has been good. But actually my track sessions, like the track session I did today compared to sort of last week. So last week was 6x1K. Today I had 2K, then 3 400s times two. And I was basically holding same pace on the 2Ks as I did on the 1Ks. And then building faster on the 400s, which, so that feels like progress, which is nice. I think generally feel in a good place. It's probably not massively different to a normal week. I'm probably just doing a little bit more on the bike than I would normally at home at this time of year. So again, like I'd say, it's probably not that different to what I would do as I'm getting more into like an Ironman block. Like I'd say probably like 30-ish hours is pretty normal around then, because I'm trying to get more bike mileage in. And actually I'd probably be adding, if anything, a bit more, because I've been doing some longer runs as well. But yeah, for this time of year, like I wouldn't be doing that many bike miles this time of year at home because of the weather and it being cold and generally rainy. So yeah, I think that's the main difference. It's just having that different environment, because again, I think, you know, I've had a few questions of like, why training camp? What are the benefits? I think the main benefit is the weather. Maybe for the first couple of weeks wasn't as good as it could have been, but it was still dry. So like, I think it got rained on once, which compared to what you can get at home in February is pretty decent. And then obviously this week it's actually been warm, which has been really nice. Generally, it's also just change of environment, some different roads to ride on, sometimes some different people to train with. But yeah, I think they're the key benefits. So for me, rather than it, I would judge it a bit based on the like, how am I feeling and what's my aura data doing. But I can see from like my trends of like resting heart rate and HRV overnight, generally like one day of sort of recovery sorts me out pretty well. So like yesterday, my resting heart rate overnight had gone back from 40, I think it was 47 on Sunday, back down to 43 on Monday. So then I'm like, well, I'm back to sort of having freshened up again. But yeah, if it was still trending high, I would dial it back a bit more, but I tend to do it more on, unless it's been a pretty ridiculous block, which would probably have to be a bit more than, there would need to be more intensity in it, because like 34 hours is quite a lot of hours training, but actually a lot of it's been really steady. Again, it's very individual, like some people would need longer to recover, but I think when you've had like 3 years of probably averaging about 23 to 25 hours a week, ish, actually it's not a massive jump up.